up, guys? Chef Q here, and today we are cooking up some goat hot pot. And in Vietnamese, it's called lau ye. It's for my wife's birthday tomorrow, so we are prepping it today. So I'm gonna have to do some grocery shopping right now. And the most important thing is the goat. So hopefully I can find some good goat meat. And usually goat is best at your local Mideastern supermarket. And luckily here in San Diego, we have a few local ones. So I'm going to check that out. And of course, I'm gonna have to go to the Asian supermarkets to pick up all the other stuff that we need too. So I'll catch you guys in the kitchen, all right? Okay, so we are back in my kitchen. Just giving you guys a heads up, this dish is a pretty complicated dish, but I'm gonna try to break it into steps to make it a lot easier. So as you can see from the ingredients, there are a lot of things. But we're going to tackle this in three steps. First is preparing the goat. Second is preparing the soup stock. And third is preparing all the other side dishes. So I'm splitting this into 2-day portion. Today we are going to work on the goat and we're going to marinate it and leave it in the fridge overnight. And then we're going to work on the broth and the side dishes the next day. It seems like there's a lot of work, which it is. I would recommend that you guys only make this for a big party. That way it will be worth it. So make sure to serve this up to plenty of people. All right, let's get started.
So this piece is pretty thick. You see how the skin is pretty thick? So we're gonna have to tenderize this. Just like this. Do this side. I know you can see these lines through here.
And then we'll just cut it into bite-sized pieces. Yeah.
The butcher kind of cut this a little bit bigger than I wanted. Can't blame him though. This is fresh goat, so it's a lot harder to cut through that machine. Now this goat is already torched. That's why you see these dark spots. So they torch it to eliminate the odor and also to burn all the hair that's still on it.
In a big pot of water, add in a couple of tablespoons of salt. Throw in a handful of smashed up lemongrass. Also one smashed up ginger root. Peel your galangal skin and add those to the pot. Also add in a splash of Chinese cooking wine.
Okay, now we dump in all of the goat and we are going to blanch these goats in this butter. So we're gonna turn the heat on high. Once it boils, leave it there for around 5 minutes. So we're gonna take it out, rinse it in cold water. After that, we're going to strain it and let it sit to dry for around 15-20 minutes. So in the meantime, you can prepare the ingredients to marinate the meat.
This galangal is very tough. It's very hard. So just cut off all the skin. And then we are going to grate it. Grate about, I think half of this would do. This I got from Japan, but you can also find it in any Asian store or most Asian store. So this grater is what they use to grate the wasabi root. Grater. Circular motion.
All
comes out to almost like a paste.
Okay, so it's been around 20 minutes, leaving it to strain. We are going to marinate our meat. So after marinade, usually I want to leave it out for at least an hour or two, just so all the flavor can get absorbed. And then I'm going to cover it and then put it in the fridge overnight. This is a lot, so I'm going to just eyeball it. When you're making it at home, adjust it so that the sugar level and the saltiness level is equal. So one and one. Okay, first we are going to put in our galangal, our grated galangal. I think that's how you pronounce it, galangala. Okay, and here I got the smashed up shallot and the smashed up garlic. This is two whole cloves of garlic and two large shallot. I'm just going to use half. The other half, we are going to use it to stir fry our meat before we put in the soup. So just half. So basically, for me, that's one clove of garlic and one shallot. One whole cloves, okay? Now this is 15 pounds, so adjust to whatever amount of meat that you have. Now this is important. So we got our fermented bean curd. So this is kind of like a salted soybean in chili sauce, but it's not that spicy. Now just use this, okay? Do not add the mixture. So this is kind of like our substitute for fish sauce, right? Then we'll add our sugar. See how many sugar here. One, two, okay, four tablespoons. One tablespoon of salt. And also about one tablespoon, or for me, two tablespoons of wine. Now this wine is going to help tenderize our meat, and also it helps cover up the goat smell. I forgot our chicken granulated powder. So you can use MSG too, but this is a substitute. MSG, you use less portion, okay? So that's 2 tablespoons. 3 tablespoons. Okay. 4 tablespoons. If it's MSG, it's probably 1/4 of that, probably 1 tablespoon. Chili oil. If you want a little bit spicy, add in the mixture of chili oil. 1, 2. Don't add too much because a lot of people can't eat spicy. Wow, so I'm going to cover this, leave it outside for 1 hour, then put it in the fridge overnight, and then tomorrow we're gonna come back and make the soup broth for this, and also all the condiments on the side too. All right. Oh, and I forgot. We are going to have to soak these dried shiitake mushroom overnight also, because these take a long time to actually soften up. So we are going to soak it in cold water is fine because we're doing overnight. But if you need it right away, soak it in hot water probably for at least 1 or 2 hours before you can use it. Another thing we need to soak is the dried jubilee. I'll probably use around 1/4 of this, but use whatever you want. This is going to sweeten up your broth. Now, if you have time, you can also prep the lotus root today also. So we are going to skin the lotus root, cut off these ends, and then slice them into bite-sized pieces. We're not going to cook them till tomorrow, but we can prep them today. So to keep them from browning, just have a bowl of cold water and add a little bit of salt. So it's the next day. As you can see, I kind of got a haircut here. But to continue on with our lau ye, or the Vietnamese goat hot pot. So I took out our goat from the fridge, which marinated overnight. So the next part is for us to prepare the broth for it. So let's focus on that
first. Now for the broth, I'm using pork bones. I'm using the pork back ribs and also the pork marrow bones. I usually start with two pots of water, one bigger and one small. The small one, we are going to blanch the bones with a little bit of salt. So when it boils, leave it for around 5 minutes. After that, we're going to strain it out and wash the bones with cold water. And after that, we are going to put it in the bigger pot and make our broth base from the pork bones. And with that, add 2 large onions, a few pieces of ginger root, 2 tablespoons of salt, about 4 to 5 ounces of rock sugar. Make sure to skim off any foam that floats to the top. Add in 2 cans of chicken broth and also 2 cans of vegetable broth. Let simmer on medium heat. And while we are cooking the broth, we are going to prep all the other stuff like the taro and all the other condiments for the dish. We'll start by prepping the mushroom we soaked yesterday. Cut off the stem and cut the mushrooms in half. Strain and set aside the mushrooms, lotus root, and jubilee. Cut the taro root into chunks and soak it in the bowl of salted water. Rinse your taro root and strain dry. Then we'll deep fry the taro root and set aside. We'll also deep fry the dried bean curd sticks. Make sure the oil is not too hot for this. These take about 5 seconds to fry up. After you take them out to dry up the oil, it will still be cooking. So make sure not to overcook these. After an hour and a half to 2 hours of simmering the pork bones, you can take out the onions, ginger root, and pork bones and discard. In a wok or pan, add in a little bit of oil, smashed up garlic and shallots, then stir fry your goat. After you get a little bit of seared on the goat, transfer it to the broth. Then add in a couple handfuls of smashed lemongrass. You can make good use of the marinated sauce from the leftover bowl. Next, toast up the herbal mix package. Toast up the mix until fragrant and put in the filter bag they provided. Drop it in the broth and also add in the lotus root, shiitake mushroom, and dried jubilee. You can taste the broth and add in more salt, rock sugar, or even fish sauce if you prefer. Adjust to your taste. Okay, so I made this bean curd sauce or gal. I've already made a video on how to make this sauce, so I'm gonna link that video somewhere up on top there, all right?
Happy birthday, babe! All right, see? So today's feast. Oh, wait, and you were actually let me. Right, so we got the taro. I put the taro on the side. Usually they put it inside with the broth to cook it. But since our broth, since our hot pot is filled with meat, so I couldn't fit that in. So we'll put it in when we want to eat it. Ooh, we got the tofu and the fried bean curd. Well, they didn't know they fried some more bean curd. These are bean curds too. Then we got our vegetables. We got the cabbage and chrysanthemum greens. Ooh, look at that. We are transferring from the big pot to the small pot for the pot, for the hot pot. Okay. Hot pot is up. Whoa, okay, buckle up. So, woo! Nhờ muốn lên YouTube nè, đó, YouTube. Good job.
Let's dunk this down. It's a lot of stuff. It is a lot of stuff. All right, you put in the noodles. Bỏ rau vô tô trước hả?
Yeah.
Put the vegetable on the bottom, or you can put it in here. Go ahead and làm làm sao đây. Let's see how you do it. There we go. Put some taro in there, some tofu. Put the vegetable on the bottom. We're just waiting on the... Oh, you gotta put this in. Oh, you gotta... Okay. Some fried bean curd in there. Ooh, check that out. Wow. Oh. Wow. That's from one. What? Two. Ah. Ngon chưa ba? Ngon không? Ngon không? Ok. Vô số 1 coi. Số 1. Quay lại.
Best present is food.
She said best present is food. So that's all you're getting, alright?
No.
Okay. For the taste test. In the sauce. That's what they say, Tess.
Is it goat?
Yes, it is goat meat.
It's very chewy, but at the same time, very tender.
I'm sorry, that's my part. I'm the one that's gonna do the explaining, all right? You just need to tell me if it's good or not.
I already said it, it's good.
Okay.
It's very good.
All right.
Excellent.
Okay. I need to see the face again.
Time right.
Go.
Okay, it's hot.
Okay. Ooh. Okay, I got my bowl. Ooh. Oh, yeah. Ah, check this out. So we got the goat here. Got our veggies. The skin. Some of the dry jubilee. There's a lot of ingredients here. And all that Chinese herbal just blend in really well with all of these flavor. Ooh. We got the crispy fried bean curd. Also this. But the main thing is the goat. So I wanna, so I have to taste the goat. Ooh. Ah, super hot. Mmm, wow.
Quiet.
Ooh, I'm gonna use my finger. All right, let's taste this. Ooh. Ooh. So tender, it just falls off the bone. Mmm, perfect. Wow. Wow. Ooh. Ooh. Just suck that the marrow of the goat. Ooh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And the skin. The skin is actually my favorite because this skin is kind of like a pork skin and a beef mixed together. That's what I think goat is. Part beef and part pork. Mm. Now this is a really tough skin, so I have to like pound it with the knife. Get some skin. Wow. Mmm. The skin is soft, but not too soft like gaggy, gelatin soft. It has a, like a crisp to it too when you bite. So a little bit crisp but soft. Mm.
Yeah. That'd be right.
Ooh. This broth though. Ooh, this broth. Mmm. Oh my god. The broth. So all the mushroom, we got the pork bones. And the dry jubilee gives it like a natural sweetness. Ooh. Oh man, oh man, oh man. Oh, and that galangal, what's that? Galangal? Galangal gives the goat, like there's no goat stench at all. Ooh, let's try the lotus root. Mmm, wow, it's so soft. It's soft, but it's just right. It's just right. Just the right. Mmm, warm. Mmm. Oh. And the mushroom. Mmm. Oh man. Oh yeah. Outdid myself. Mmm. Mmm. This tofu sucked up all of the broth. So when you bite into it, it just bursts out of the broth. Mm. I know that. So all right, I'm going to finish up my bowl here and we'll catch you next time, all right? Peace.
Okay, say remember to subscribe.
Remember to subscribe our channel.
Yeah, our channel. Say remember to subscribe to our channel. Too long? Okay. Remember?
The number?
To?
To?
Subscribe?
Subscribe?
To?
To?
Chef Q?
Chef Q?
Channel?
Channel!
Yeah! I'm off! Hi! Back! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, dear wifey. Happy birthday to you.
Oh my god, how do you smell?
Yeah.